On New Zealand dollar for today, New Zealand dollar has been on this daily drop. So we want to watch this present correction they are making here for more drops to down towards this low. This is said we want to watch out for today. On New Zealand dollar is going to four-hour time frame. On the four-hour time frame, you see they are presently attempting this correction. We want to watch them to see if they will give us a flat here for the drop downside. So we want to watch out for this drop today. We're also going to the 1 hour time frame on New Zealand dollar. On the 1 hour time frame, we want to watch this for potential to drop down and then one more spike upside, make this running flat, and then they give us opportunity to get into the set to the downside to tag this loop. We want to watch out for these sets today on New Zealand dollar. So we'll be on lookout for them as they develop. We're drawing this trend. Dollar Swiss for today. Dollar Swiss is presently on this daily upside momentum. So right now it's attempting to start a sideways correction. Here we want to see them give us a flat here before they resume the climb upside. Resume to 4 hour time frame on Dollar Swiss. On the 4 hour time frame, see they gave this up move and they gave a correction here. Another up move. We want to watch this for another correction. For a bigger up move, expect a bigger correction here. So if we zoom to the 1 hour time frame on the last series and the 1 hour time frame, we want to watch this as a potential flat structure for more drop downside to give us this ABC structure before they take off to the upside. So we want to watch out for this today on the last series. So we'll be on lookout for that, especially a correlative structure here on one more drop down. On dollar yen for today, dollar yen is presently on this upside corrective structure right now. So we expect more of this correction to continue a bit throughout today, Friday. We zoom to 4 hour time frame on Aussie yen. On dollar yen, you see they give us this drop and they pulled back upside. So we want to watch for a potential drop back down to make this a running flat before they resume this climb upside. So I want to watch out for this drop today on dollar yen. We zoom to 1 hour time frame. The 1 hour time frame, see this as an attempt at the retest of this top, potentially to give us a flat here and then climb upside more before this bigger drop to give us A, B, C. Or this can break through downside at this moment and then drop. On dollar card for today, dollar card is presently at this daily top level. We expect them to start correction downside for us here. So if we zoom to 4 hour time frame on dollar card, on the 4 hour time frame, I want to see this drop here as start of bigger drops to come through for us. We are still looking at this possibility here for the reason this climb upside. We zoom to 1 hour time frame to look at that better. On the 1 hour time frame, we see that there is divergence between these tops and these tops, which tells us that this wave is likely incoming. This drop down is likely incoming here. So we want to watch out for these sales today. We want to watch out for this correction, drop. Euro Swiss for today. Euro Swiss still has this divergence between the MACD and the chart, which tells us that this up move is still incoming. We expect an up move on Euro Swiss to the upside. So if we zoom to 4 hour time frame on Euro Swiss, on the 4 hour time frame, this drop tagged this low, which completed this. If we look at both of these as corrections, this drop completed them. So we want to watch them start an upside momentum at this moment. So if we zoom to 1 hour time frame on Euro Swiss, on the 1 hour time frame, we are presently looking at this as impulse upside and this A, B, C as the correction. So we wait for this drop to tag this low and then we watch for it to give us buy opportunity upside. We're looking for buy upside on Euro Swiss. So I want to watch out for On Eurozy for today, Eurozy has been on this upside momentum, so we want to watch them correct here for us potentially drop back down a bit before they resume this climb for more drops to come through. As we are looking at this as potential flat for more drops. So if we zoom to 4-hour time frame on Eurozy, on the 4-hour time frame we see they gave us this climb, they gave a correction here and they climbed back up. So we want to watch for at least a bigger correction here before they resume this climb upside. So we want to watch out for these sales on Eurozy. If we zoom to 1-hour time frame, on the 1-hour time frame we see they gave us, after this drop, they gave a complete ABC flat here. So we want to watch for this to drop downside a bit more for us. Side sales we want to watch out for today on Eurozy before they resume this climb. They are going to resume the climb upside. So we want to watch out for this sell opportunity as we draw in this. On Eurocard for today, Eurocard has been on this sideways correction of this up move. So we want to watch them continue this sideways before they resume this climb upside. Expect them to correct sideways here. So if we zoom to 4-hour time frame on Eurocard, on the 4-hour time frame we see this as a wave. This was the correction and this was the third drop. So this is the start of another correction. So we want to watch this correct here a bit to give us another A, B, C, which will make this A wave, this B wave, and one more drop for C wave. So if we zoom to 1-hour time frame, on the 1-hour time frame we expect this to drop more to the downside. We expect it to correct here and drop further down before it goes one more spike upside that will make this A wave, this B, and one more drop for C before they will start this climb momentum upside. So we want to watch.